Santa Claus mix things up.
It was awfully funny, but very embarrassing. And many people decided to just let it go and forget about it.
But we decided to tell you all about it. So sit back and listen as we tell the tale.
So Santa works all year to be ready for Christmas, and there are lots and lots of children. So that means lots and lots of work.
Ho, 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 I don't mind it a bit, though. The children are worth it.
We love you, Santa!
Anyway, sometimes Santa does get much sleep or rest, but he still loves his job. Kind of like teachers.
Well, one year about Thanksgiving Day, Santa Claus had been working nonstop for 24 hours. Boy, was he tired.
He should have gone to bed, but he decided to get some coffee and keep working.
I'm so tired. I let the elves go home hours ago. I should be in bed, but there's so much work to do. I guess I'll get another cup of coffee and try to get a little more work done. Better watch out. You better not pout. You better not cry. I'm telling you why. I am coming to town. I know when you're sleeping. I know when you're... Yikes!
With a loud shout and an even louder crash, remember, Santa's a big guy. Santa fell down and hit his head hard.
Santa lost consciousness.
That means he fell asleep or passed up a nut.
Remember, it was late at night. Anyway, there was Santa on the floor. He may have looked normal, but something was wrong.
Ooh, boy, is my head hurting. What happened? Candy canes and sugar cookies? Where am I?
Santa had a concussion. That means that his brain had gotten damaged.
Poor Santa!
Let me see. Ouch, my head. I'm Santa Claus. I must be okay. I was getting some coffee, but I think I was just going to go to bed.
Santa went off to bed, thinking everything was okay. In the morning, he went back to work. That's when things started going wrong.
Santa, we made a half amount of candy canes we need for Christmas. We're about to start another batch. What flavor should we make?
Candy canes? Ho, ho, ho. No, no, no. Don't make candy canes. Make chocolate bunnies.
Okay, chocolate bunnies. Oh, wait a minute, Santa.
Make chocolate bunnies.
Okay, Santa, you are the boss. Santa, Santa, what should we make to put in the stockings for North America?
Let's see, what did we put in them last year?
Oranges, some small chocolates, and cereal.
Ho, ho, ho. No, no, no. Fill the stockings with baby teeth and a dollar or two.
What?
I said fill the stockings with baby teeth and a dollar or two. And when you're done, we can hide them so children can hunt for them.
Okay, Santa, you are the boss.
What? So what for?
gone from a big fight once a year to lots of fights every night. I'm so tired. If this keeps up, I'm going to have to change my name from Comet to Creeper.
The reindeer weren't happy, the elves weren't happy, and the people of the world were beginning to get upset too.
Strike. I don't mean to bug you, Santa. We can't take it anymore. Please, you've got to give us a break. We've never had a Christmas like this before.
This might have gone forever with everyone getting angrier and angrier. With nothing being done, elves and reindeer might have quit, and Christmas would be ruined forever if there's no one knowing what poor Santa's head. If the League of Mythical Creatures hadn't gotten involved.
I'm telling you, he's after our jobs!
No, he isn't.
Then what is he doing? He's mixed up, that's all. He's mixed up or he's mixing us up.
Do you know he sent me a Valentine's?
He's ruining Halloween. How are witches like me supposed to be scary when there's no sun and candy cane hanging on pumpkins? It's terrible.
Huh? You know he's made plans to kidnap himself? Am I going to steal Christmas that way? That's nothing, Grinch. He left sand in my diaper. You know how hard it is shooting people with arrows when they're itching?
Ha! I can beat that one, Cupid. He left a rotten Easter egg under the President of the United States' daughter's pillow. Instead of a dollar, and now the Secret Service is after me.
That's nothing, sister. You know he nicked the nose of the Queen of England and left a patch of ice in her bathroom? He slipped and landed on the floor when it was most inconvenient. And now I, Jack Frost, am not allowed in England at all. If they catch me there, they have directed to bring back the firing squad.
So what are we going to do about it?
Well, they divided the boat long into the night. Then decided they would all go talk to Santa and discuss it with him. It's just several days till Christmas. When they show up at Santa's door at the North Pole, he's decorated in orange and black, his pumpkin flying in the window.
They rang the doorbell. Santa opened the door, holding a bowl of candy.
Well, don't you all look so cute? I love your costumes. Here, have some candy.
No, we're not here to trick or treat.
Hey, think for yourself. I want the candy bar.
Look, Santa, we're here to pick a bone with you.
A bone? I thought you picked apples. What do you guys want to pick bones?
Okay. No, Santa, what they mean is we need to talk.
Somehow, the League of Mythical Creatures got Santa to let them inside, and everyone took a seat in Santa's living room.
Santa, we're here because you're ruining our jobs.
Oh, you need a job? Well, I've got plenty of elves, but I could always use some extra help, I suppose. What are your qualifications?
Well, I can turn fat men with beards into fluffy bunny rabbits.
Now, I'm sure we can all be adults about this.
After a frustrating minute or two, the League of Mythical Creatures patiently explained to Santa Claus what was going on. Santa was shocked. I can't believe it. We all have the same job?
Okay, so it took a little longer than just a few minutes to get them straightened up. Santa just couldn't believe what they were saying.
I can't believe it. What was I thinking? I guess I know most of the jobs that you guys are supposed to have. What about my job? What exactly am I supposed to be doing?
Well, if you ask me, I think you'd be getting ready to let me steal Christmas from you.
Well, the League of Mythical Creatures started explaining, but that they wouldn't or couldn't understand at all.
Most people don't know this, but Santa and Mrs. Claus have different jobs. He doesn't agree with the work kitchen, and she doesn't agree with the workshop.
Well, in the mix-up, Santa hadn't been following their deal. Mrs. Claus had just found out from her kitchen note what he'd been doing in her kitchen.
Like taking all of her eggs and dyeing them, taking all of the turkeys and stuffing them full of confetti, and worst of all, putting Valentine's candy inside her Christmas pie.
Mr. Santa, how dare you?
Mrs. Claus said it was a shout that could be heard all over the North Pole.
Do I interfere with your business? She shouted at him. Then boom!
She called for Santa on his already bruised head.
Wow, nice job. It would have been better though with a broom.
Everyone gathered around concerned. Now we're